Through the pouring rain, howling winds, and even some fog, some teams can now see it. A state championship is at the light at the end of this tunnel of the 2022 football season. Welcome to the Level 3 playoff edition of the High School Blitz. The winners tonight are one game away from a trip to Madison and a season to remember for the ages. We start in Division 1, Sussex Hamilton traveling to Arrowhead. Opening drive of the game, Nate Kolath with the screen to Kyle Lavoie, and he goes 21 yards for the Chargers, but they don't score. The Warhawks then get pinned deep, so Vance Holtz drops back and fires from his own end zone, finding Andrew Weske downfield. Now that puts their offense in a great spot because they give it to Nick Sinelli, and he runs it in from 23 yards out. It's 6-0 Arrowhead. Now turnovers, a big key in this one. Connor Foley with the pick for the Warhawks, and that goes well, right? But then on the other side, it's Austin Eklund, and he recovers the Warhawks' fumble. And that's big for the Chargers because Hamilton wins a hard-fought game 15-13. Well, they finished the season tied atop the Classic 8 standings. They each have 10-1 records. And the only difference is that Mukwonago beat Muskego all the way back in Week 5 of the season. Tonight, the rivalry means so much more as both have state championship aspirations. Here's Lily Zhao with the story of our High School Blitz Game of the Week.
No amount of rain could stop these two conference foes from showing out in a big Level 3 matchup. Mukwonago flexed their muscles on the road against Muskego in the first half. On their opening drive, Wynn Stang punches it in from 3 yards out for the score. On the very next drive, watch this effort from Gavin Adams, who just takes the ball away and rumbles the other direction for the touchdown as Mukwonago takes the 13-0 lead. The Blue and Gold's defense was stout. On the very last play of the first half, they're going to stuff Max Schneider, making the goal line stand to keep the Warriors out of the end zone. Muskego battles back in the second half, and the Warriors respond on their opening drive as Braden Horn throws a perfect ball to Lewis Schwabe for the 25-yard touchdown. It's a one-score game. But Stang gives Mukwonago some breathing room with this 4-yard touchdown run. They go up 20-7. The Warriors keep battling back. In the fourth quarter, it's Sam Stoiber who goes up the gut for the 2-yard score. It's now a 20-14 ball game. Muskego has another prime opportunity to drive down the field, but Mukwonago's defense has other plans. It's a pick six for Owen Kilton, and that's the difference in this game. Fueled by a dominant defensive performance, Mukwonago advances with a 27-14 win.
It feels amazing. It's definitely the ultimate goal. I think all the way back from the summer, doing sled pulls and every ounce in conditioning, waking up in the morning, it's for this. For the playoffs, it's for what we dream of and we think of. That's a great football team, and that was a good score, and our guys did our job.
The second straight year, Mukwonago will end Muskego's season in Level 3 of the playoffs, and as for the Blue and Gold themselves, they're one step closer to a trip to Camp Randall. Reporting from Muskego High School, Lily Zhao, Fox 6 Sports.
And they face Hamilton next week. Division 2 taking us to Homestead High School, where the Highlanders are hosting Kakana. Down 7-0 in the first, Sal Ballesteri connecting with Will Van Lannen on third down. And look at the moves here, juking two ghost players, and he goes 47 yards for the score. The two-point conversion fails, so Kakana still leads 7-6. In the second quarter, ghosts on third down, trying to grind out the first, but Nick Wolt isn't having any of that. Homestead forcing the punt. Highlanders now trailing 13-6 and going for it on fourth down. Ballesteri to Van Lannen connecting again. Look at that over-the-shoulder catch. That's fantastic. However, they failed to score on the drive, and Kakana wins big, 41-13. In another Division II matchup, Kettle Moraine at home against Sun Prairie East. Chase Spellman and Drew Wagner get the lasers going by throwing caution to the wind, and it works. A long touchdown, and it's a 6-0 lead after he reaches Pater. Kettle Moraine now up 12-6, and the weather playing a factor. The ball slipping right out of Jerry Kaminsky's hands, and Jonathan Sobiek recovers for the lasers, putting their offense back in business. On the ensuing drive, they go to the ground, and that's where Nolan Schopp takes over. He goes 36 yards for the touchdown. Kettle Moraine wins big 27-6 as they move on to the semifinal. Two 9-win teams facing off in Division III, New Berlin West at Port Washington. Opening drive for the Pirates, they go with the option, and Leighton Allen is the perfect decoy because Ben Fritz holds on to it, and he goes 34 yards for the score, 8-0 Port. Now Vikings looking for an answer, keeping it on the ground. Jack Wisolowski picking up 10 yards on the carry. Then on the very next play is Tony Blowett going right up the gut, 26 yards for the touchdown. New Berlin West moves on to face Monroe with their 49-35 win. Catholic Memorial putting their 11-0 record on the line against 9-2 Lodi in Division 4. The Crusaders up 20-0 to start the third. Isaiah Nathaniel from the shotgun launching one to Corey Smith, and he makes a nice grab for a 48-yard reception. But after the drive stalls, the defense gets the points. The Blue Devils with a bad snap, and that turns into a Catholic Memorial safety. On the ensuing drive, P.J. Reynolds sees some daylight, and he goes all the way from 35 yards out. Catholic Memorial blanks Lodi 35-0. They improve to 12-0 and reach a state semifinal against Two Rivers.
Yeah, it was great. You know, having my James and Elsie and my wife Gail and my Sarah and David and Brad, you know, it's been football has been a big, big middle part of our life, you know. Faith, family, and football, that's what we do for the youngs.
It's time to take a look through Leach's lens. Award-winning photojournalist Mickey Lee showing us how the heavy rains brought out the heavy equipment. The cross-country and track teams letting their tents help shelter the football team. Now, the sharing goes a long way in this one, as staying dry was very difficult on such a stormy night. We go to Division 6, St. Mary Springs traveling to Coleman, down 6-0. The Ledgers get on the board in the second. JT Conan getting in for the score. That's a 7-6 lead. At the end of the half, it's Conan again. This time, it's a big one, 50 yards, 14-6 at the break. Conan would have three touchdowns. St. Mary's wins 21-20 as they move on to the semifinal.